It's absolutely fantastic to have you here for us today. Can you start by giving us a little bit of background to this extraordinary story?
Yeah, well, in 2006, we were looking for a house for my mum to live in. And we needed a very large place that my sister and my mother would probably sell both their houses and pool resources so lots of generations could live together. I was in France thinking, I was writing a book about animal intelligence, and I thought, well, that'll be great for mum. The estate agent's details came through the door of this big house with lots of bedrooms, very run down, but seven tigers and three lions and three bears and a pack of wolves in the garden. And so, of course, we just laughed at first, well, this is mad. But we made the mistake of going to see it, and then, of course, fell in love with it and realized that if we didn't buy it, a lot of the animals would be destroyed. And so something in the whole family just clicked, and we thought, right, we have to do this. And that's what we've been doing ever since.
It's such a unique story. Why do you think so many people have connected with it, and why it makes such an appropriate subject for a film?
Well, I really struggled with why they would make a film about it. And this is going to be my fourth time of seeing the film now, because I've been to several premieres in different countries. And I get it now. It's obviously the first few times, the personal information, because it's very, very personal about my wife, the death of my wife, which is a big part of the film, a big reason that people should see this film, because it deals with that subject so well. But also, stepping back and you think, well, they bought a zoo. This guy bought a zoo and turned it round and made it open to the public again and saved the animals. That's good. You know, we did do that. And it's an uplifting story.
What was it like working with Cameron Crowe and the wonderful Matt Damon?
I didn't work with them, really. I did visit the set, and Cameron Crowe was kind enough to let me sit next to him while he was working. I asked him, as a director, how do you know? And, you know, everyone else just sees the images on the monitor flickering, and they all sort of pounce, that one now, that we've got it in the can. I said, what's the difference? And he said, come and see. And he sat me down with him, and it was very, very interesting experience. It was inside an exact replica of our tiger house in Devon, and he'd reproduced it exactly in Hollywood. And there was a big tiger, which is very familiar territory to me, and there was a huge camera behind it, which is unusual, and there was Matt Damon dressed as me, and he said, okay, for this scene, Benjamin Mee needs to stand up. So I thought, okay, so I started to stand up, and he goes, no, not you, him over there. And that was when it really started to hit me that it was very unusual experience.
Obviously, you've seen the film a few times. What do you think audiences are going to get from particularly Matt's performance and the film overall as well?
Well, I heard front row recently, Radio 4, Mark Lawson, who is a tough cookie, gave it an outstanding review because of the range of Damon's performance. And that is the thing. You can really see some acting here. And I was very moved watching him on set. And listening to him talk about the whole thing as well and his motivation behind it. He's a very thoughtful man, giving a thoughtful performance in a thoughtful film. So I think bring a hanky.